let's consider the addition of each of the standard form. To add standard form, the powers of the 10 must be the same. Because these are the same, I'm going to go ahead to solve this problem. Step number one, I'm going to add the numbers. In the next step, which is step number two, 10 to the power of 3 are the same. Hence, I will multiply this with 10 to the power of 3. Next, 4 plus 3, and you're going to have 7. And this is your answer. Let's consider this question. The first step is to check if the tens are the same. Since they are the same, I will go ahead with the addition. The first step is I'm going to add the numbers. Next, in step number two, I will multiply this with 10 to the power of 6, since both are the same. Next, I will add 5 and 12. Next, 17 is greater than 10. I will move the decimal one step to the front to have 1.7. And because of this, this 6 will increase to become 10 to the power of 7. And this becomes our answer. Next, let's consider this question. The powers of the 10 are not the same. For me to go on with the addition of this standard form, I'm going to make both equal, that is, making the powers the same. This will remain this, while this will become this. 10 to the power of 1 multiply 10 to the power of 5 will give you 10 to the power of 6. Both are the same. Next, 3 times 10 will give you 30. 10 to the power of 5, and this is 10 to the power of 5. Now we can add both standard form. Next, 2, we add 30. Next, in step number 2, since these are the same, I will multiply this with 10 to the power of 5. 2 plus 30 is 32. Next, 32 is greater than 10. Next, you move decimal from the back of 2 so that you have 3.2. And this movement will increase this 5 to 10 to the power of 6. And this becomes our answer. In this exercise, complete the table. Next, let's consider the subtraction of standard form. Let's solve each of this task. To solve this first problem, consider if the power of the tens are the same. Since they are the same, let's subtract. 6 will subtract 1.5. Next, since the powers are the same, I will multiply this by 10 to the power of 8. 6 minus 1.5. 4.5 is between 1 and 10. This is our answer. Next, let's consider this question. The tens are the same, which is 10 to the power of 4. Hence, we are going to subtract 7.5 minus 3.8. Next, since the power of the 10 are the same, I'm going to multiply this with 10 to the power of 4. Next, 7.5 minus 3.8. 3.7 is between 1 and 10. And this is our answer. Next, consider this question. Here, you can see that the powers are not the same. The first step is to make them equal. Next, if you input this directly into your calculator, this is converted internally in your calculator without you even knowing it. Next, 13 will subtract 18,000 and you will have minus 17,987. Next, 10 to the power of 12 are the same. Hence, I will just take only 1, which is 10 to the power of 12. Next, this value is less than 1. Next, I will move the decimal from the back to 1, 2, 3, 4. And because my movement is towards the left, I will add 4 to this 12 to become 10 to the power of 16. And this is our answer. If this video was helpful, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share with your friends. To locate other helpful videos, follow the link on the screen. I will see you in the next video lesson.